Hello, I'm Samriddhi Srivastava and you are watching DME TV Ek Nayi Soch. Today, BBA department of DME is having a string meet of HR success. The guest lecturer of the event was Mr. Govind Singh Sir, who is the director of talent engagement. So let's get in conversation with Govind Singh Sir. We're glad to have you, sir, in our college. So my first question is, tell us about your organization to us.
Basically, I work for an organization called 3-Pillar Global, and this organization is into IT. We develop IT software for US-based clients. We have almost 1,000 people across the globe. One of our offices is in Noida. We are in Sector 62. We have around 350 people in Noida. We have around 450 people in Romania and around 60 people in US. A couple of people in London as well. So our main purpose of this organization is to develop softwares for US-based clients.
Okay, so my next question is, what are the main challenges the HR industry is facing in today's scenario?
So I think one of the things which I was talking about, when we hire people, or even the people who are on board right now, they are technically sound with what they are doing. So basically I'm from the IT industry, so I'll talk about people. They're very good in coding, writing the software. But are they a good and ideal team player? That's the question. We are not more focused on our technical skills, as opposed to we are more focused on the way the persons are found culturally fit with the organization. When I talk about ideal team player, what I meant by is that the person who is humble, who is smart, who is hungry. So does this person has all those attributes in it or not? When I talk about HR, so one of the key aspects is finding people who are actually culturally fit to the organization. And nowadays, this is becoming more and more important for us and challenging as well. So finding those people, making sure that people who are already on the board are aligned with the culture of the organization, are ideal team player. So that's one of the challenges which we are facing strongly. The other part of it is that developing leaders. So everybody wants to grow in the organization, in their professional life. But very few have that kind of skill set to grow up in the ladder. So when you grow up, most of us grow up in the leadership role. Whether we become a manager or we become a mid-manager, or later on we become more than a manager in the organization where we play more strategic role. I feel leadership is one of the skill which is very rare, and organizations face a lot of difficulties in finding right kind of leader. So one of the challenge the HR people face is to how to develop, first of all, how to identify those leaders, and then how to develop those leaders or people who are potential to be a leaders to a leadership role. That's our biggest challenge which we face nowadays. Other one is, and the third one is, making sure that people are growing up in the ladder. As I said, everybody wish to grow up in the ladder. If today somebody is a software engineer too, wish to be a senior software engineer. If you're a senior software engineer, they wish to be a module leader. But the problem comes when they don't know what they need to do to go to the next level. What kind of skill they need to develop, both technical and non-technical. So I feel that's the biggest challenge for HR. First, to make people understand that organization will be more than happy to grow people within. But at the same time, it is up to the person to understand what is required to go up in the ladder. One, second, put efforts to go to that level. I would say organization should support people. Organization should make sure that people are clear about it, and all kind of help they need to move up in the ladder should be provided to them. So I think these are the three main challenges which are is facing an organization nowadays, specifically in IT industry.
So as a management student, the student of BBA department, how should they prepare themselves for future, for the management industry or for the human resource industry?
So first of all, people who would like to start their career in human resource has to understand that it is not simply a support function. That era has gone where HR was supposed to be a support function, a function which is just doing performance management or doing some paperwork or helping people to hire. It's more than that. And organizations have started understanding the impact of human resources or that function in the organization. They know if they are hiring right kind of people. They know if they have right kind of team member in their they will be able to scale. They will be able to achieve any objective in the organization. If they don't have people who are culturally fit, who are right fit for the organization, who are a good team player, I don't think organization can achieve any target they set for themselves. Now, this is where the role of the HR becomes very important. So for my advice to the people who are from the management and willing to start their career in HR is to first understand that it is not an easy job. I see a lot of people have the mindset that it's going to be an easy job, we're going to be sitting and not, you know, it's a indoor job. But I think the lot is on stake, and that's the reason companies started segregating the HR operation work from real HRD work. And if I take example of 3-pillar global, our department is called talent engagement. And the only objective which we have is to make sure our people are engaged. Now, sounds very easy. You know, you have to make people engaged. Sometimes people understand that making people engaged means making them happy. No, we can make happy by giving people double the salary the market is giving. I can make them happy often by not doing anything they want to do, but that's not the case. The case is that how these people are engaged with the organization's objective. Do they know where organization is going? Do they see themselves growing in the organization with the organization? That's the real job which we have. And for that, there's no straight line that we need to follow. We need to work 360 degrees. We have to work on the performance management. We need to say that whether we are growing our people properly, we have to see whether people know where they can grow. We have to develop our people. We have to continuously invest in the learning and development part of it. That's where my advice to the people who are coming from this, from the management schools, to take a job in HR, do come. It's an awesome, awesome career option. But come with the mindset that it's gonna be most impactful to the organization. HR is a strategic partner today and not the support function. If the person understands that perspective, they are absolutely in and they're absolutely welcome in HR industry.
That was wonderful to know, sir. And at last, I would like to ask your experience in our college DME.
Oh, that was awesome. The moment I entered in the college and the ambience, it was awesome ambience. I like the big spacious space one. I was interacting with some of your faculties and HODs, especially Mrs. Sharma. She spent a lot of time with us. Dr. Ajaz spends a lot of time with us. The one thing which I liked about the faculty member here, other than the MBAs, is that they think so much about the student. They were thinking about not only giving them theoretical knowledge, they don't want to miss any chance by which the students here can get exposure of industry. They are ready to go to any limits to make sure that people are aware what is going on in the industry, how they can get best out of it, how they can interact with more and more people. And I would say this is one of the part of the networking. If the college and the faculties and the management of the college is connected with good corporates and people in the corporate, one, they will be able to make their student learn what is happening in the corporate, and second, they will be able to place them quickly, because that's where the connection works a lot. So I like the ambience, I like the management and the faculties. They are very foreseeing. I love the students. They were paying the attention to what we are saying, and I hope that they have got best out of what has been discussed today. And I'm sure that some of them, if they implement some of the learnings which has been told, that's going to be a game changer in their life.
Thank you so much, sir.